when Superman is, you know, he's super powered by our yellow sun, and Krypton has a red one. So I was wondering in the show if there was going to be any kind of a superhuman element to that, since we're kind of shifting the setting a little. If you could tell us about that.
Yeah, sure. There will be, but it won't be, you know, coming from, like, Segel, the star of our show, the, you know, our main character. But there will be characters with powers in the show. But it's not because of the yellow sun.
Okay. But, yeah. Okay. Had a nerd moment. Thank you.
Yeah.
What would you say is the tone of the show? How would you describe it?
The tone? It's a grounded world, even though it's on a, you know, it's a sci-fi show. But it's a world that you know, is in the middle of a kind of a really, the political climate there is Krypton's kind of tearing itself apart. It's become divided in classes. There's the underclass known as the Rankless, and then there's the upper class who are the House of Zod and the House of Valen, and they kind of live up in these kind of towers, and the Rankless live below. So that sort of political and there's a tension there that's really helpful.
It's interesting, there's a difference in class then, almost. So you're telling almost the difference in, is that kind of what the story is a little bit, like one class against each other?
That's the background, that's the world that we're in, and it's a big part of the storytelling, yeah. And I think that Seg starts out as a member of that upper class, and then he's cast down into the Rankless, and so he's really disconnected from the House of El and the everything that kind of stands for. So part of the journey of the show is him learning what that means, what it is to be an El, and the responsibility that sort of is associated with that, and the power of that kind of that symbol. And he's a much more kind of rough and tumble. He's from the streets. He's not a hero, you know. And he's very quickly thrust into a situation where he needs to become that. But that's really the journey of the series, is him growing. You know, it's a hero's journey. You know, and he has to sort of take all those steps that we sort of know in a hero's journey.
Will there be any like familiar villains?
Absolutely.
Yeah. So, is there any way you could maybe toss a couple out there for us? Or?
Well, look, without getting into the specifics of the villains, what I'll say is there's a way to kind of get into the show. And I think one of the challenges I think a lot of prequels face is, you know, the sense that, well, we know how this story ends. Krypton is going to blow up, and that's the end. So why do I invest in it? Well, what we're doing with our show, and it speaks to the villains, is that there's a conspiracy to where some villains from present day Earth 2017 have traveled back in time to Krypton of 200 years ago to try and prevent Superman's birth. So very quickly the show becomes, it's no longer about the events of the past, it's about, the stakes are about the here and now, and about, you know, the greatest hero on Earth, in the universe, and will he be born? And so it very, very early on, it becomes a show where anything can happen now. And at the, you know, at the forefront of all of that are the villains who are kind of behind this conspiracy. And you know, I think for obvious reasons, I can't go into any more detail on the specifics of who they are, but it's a very cool way to get into the show, and it just kind of, I think, upends people's expectations of what the series is going to be.
So you almost have two different stories going on there. You have that present day aspect, but you also have this path of redemption type aspect from the House of El. How long, for the redemption type story, how long do you kind of feel like you want to let that breathe before you sort of hit that climactic moment? Do you want to let that breathe a little bit, or do you want to let that kind of stretch out?
Yeah, it's a good question. I think that's the challenge of the show, is knowing, you know, how far to play any of those things, and you know, and I think it's we have a pretty well thought out plan for how that should play. And I think we want to, you know, we've got that great bonding, but ultimately we want people to invest in the characters of the show. So it's the character story, it's their personal, emotional character-driven stories that I think is what people will end up coming back for, you know? So as much as we all love the big swings and the big, wild, crazy plot moments, they only work when we care about the characters, you know? So it's about really expanding those characters and building, because a lot of the audience are going to be unfamiliar with a lot of these characters, so really growing them is an important part.